Hello YouTube, Bushcraft Woods Devil here. A few months ago I was talking to a friend of mine and he told me a story that I just really would have had a hard time believing had it not come from him, because I know he's a straight up guy and doesn't tell untruths. And he was telling me about he and another guy were working with a young person. And something came up, and they told this young person to go perform a task, and they told him not to John Wayne it. And the young person, I guess, was puzzled and said, "John Wayne? Who's John Wayne? What does that mean?" And they were just blown away that a young person would not know who John Wayne was, the actor, and of all the great westerns and war dramas, and actually a lot of films, not just westerns and war films, but he was really surprised. And I worry about young people not knowing about Louis L'Amour. Louis L'Amour is, to my mind, one of the greatest fiction writers in America. He died in the, I believe, early to mid 1980s. There's a picture of him on the back of this book here. Really interesting guy. Didn't have a lot of formal education. Held a lot of different diverse jobs. Traveled the world. Was extremely well read, even though not well educated. He had read a lot and had an extensive list of books that he considered essential reads. He had been born in the Midwest, I want to say South Dakota, during a time where he knew, his family knew Indians and knew lawmen and outlaws even of the Old West period that had been around. So he had quite a life of experience. Now, his main writing field was in westerns because of his upbringing and experience. But apparently he was always trying to break out of that mold. He didn't want to get typecast as a western writer. So he worked really hard to write other stories. And this book here, and I have three copies, Last of the Breed, is one of the most incredible and enjoyable survival stories you'll ever read. And it deals with a U.S. Air Force pilot that's this takes place in during the Cold War and in Siberia. It's a U.S. Air Force pilot who is brought down by the Soviets and escapes a prisoner of war camp, and it turns into an epic hunt for him. Now, he's a Native American by heritage and had grown up with knowledge and skills passed on to him by his family and his grandparents. And it kind of turns into this epic survival story. And one thing that's really interesting about Louis L'Amour's story is that he knew survival skills. And that comes across really well in his reading. In reading his books, one of the books that I enjoy is Callaghan, which deals with the desert southwest in the California-Arizona Yuma territory, and a lot of interesting descriptors of gathering water and how to purify it. Another great book that has a lot of different survival aspects is collected short stories. There are a number of stories in here. One of the things Louis L'Amour talks about is using like a gold pan to gather charcoal from a campfire and then filling it with water so that the impurities attach to the charcoal and then siphoning the water off, and then it's drinkable. Very interesting you know, we all know that activated charcoal can be used for filtering water, and I've heard of people using campfire charcoal to filter water through. I've never tried it. I can't vouch for it, but I would have to say that Louis knew something about this. But these are really great stories. And then now this is a modern story, probably set like in the 1970s or thereabouts. And then this is an interesting book he wrote. Not so much a survival story, but Louis L'Amour's Haunted Mesa is kind of a supernatural tale that I really don't know how else to describe it beyond that. It's a supernatural kind of a tale and a mystery and almost kind of science fiction as it deals with two dimensions. So Louis was really trying to branch out and break out of that Wild West mode. But anyway, I wanted to share that with you. And today I just picked up the new release, which is Louis L'Amour's Lost Treasures, Last of the Breed. And I'm really looking forward to reading this because the Lost Treasures is a whole new series that are coming out. And these deal with, they have a chapter in the back of the book dedicated to how he researched the story and notes that he made and how he developed the story. One thing that was really interesting about Louis L'Amour was that he often went out and actually researched the region or area where he was going to set a story. He actually hiked the ground and stood on it, excuse me, and made written notes and his impressions. There's a bit video on YouTube of him narrating, I believe, how notes that he was making about the story, The Haunted Mesa. And it's really interesting. He was a keen observer, and he was describing the wind through the trees and the sound of water and the different trees that were growing in the vicinity and how it felt on his skin. I mean, it just... you know, when you're a writer, you have to convey to the reader all of those details so that the reader comes away feeling that they've been there, that they've experienced it. It's not just reading a story, it's experiencing a story. And so I'm really looking forward to reading this story again. It's been a while. This is an original. This is like a first edition hardback. And then this is a copy that was... in circulation for many years. One thing that's really interesting is they always have just really fantastic cover art. Here we have Joe Makatazi, the Air Force Major who's fleeing from the Soviets, and he's being chased by a Hind 24 gunship, which, if you remember the Soviet invasion of Afghanistan, this helicopter played a major role in causing problems for the Mujahideen fighters, heavily armored gunship. So, yeah, really cool artwork. So I'm really looking forward to reading this. But again, if you haven't heard of Louis L'Amour, you don't know his work, and you want to read some really outstanding stories and stories that often have survival skills and knowledge in them, pick up a Louis L'Amour book, and I would highly recommend you start with Last of the Breed. You just won't be disappointed in it. Get out there and read it by campfire. Just an awesome tale. So I thought I'd share that with you. And you guys take care and have a great day.